Monkey Queen board game slash. It's a two-player abstract board game played on a square checkerboard that was invented by Mark Steere in 2011. You can play on different size boards as well as different size amount of what we call monkey babies on this game. The game starts with two monkey queens, one stack of 20 ivory colors. One's there. I had a sneeze there. one stack of ivory colored checkers and another of cigar. One stack of ivory colored checkers and another of cigar, as shown on the following picture. So one's ivory and one's a cigar.
So one of us is a monkey queen and the other one's just a stack of cigars.
A player wins if he captures the opponent's queen or leaves the opponent without any legal moves. Players move are starting with the ivory player, so I think that's me for this game. You move your queen,
and you leave a monkey behind.
And it moves the same as queen and checkers. Any number of squares along a straight, diagonal, or horizontal line. A piece, either a monkey queen or baby, may not jump over another piece, may land on a square occupied by an opponent's piece. So there's capture. Either monkey or baby. In this case, the opponent's piece is captured and removed from the board. If the capture piece is the opponent's monkey queen, then the game ends and the player wins the game. There are two additional rules about non-capturing moves. When a monkey queen makes a non-capturing move, it gives birth to a baby. The queen leaves its bottom checker behind on the original square, reducing the stack height by one. If the height of the queen is only two checkers, the queen cannot make a non-capturing move. Oh. I don't know if we've ever got down to two checkers. You can play with less. When a baby makes a non-capturing move, it must move towards the opponent's queen. I.e., the straight line distancing between your baby and the opponent's queen must be shortened by your move. So babies must, if they move on their own, they must go closer to the queen, and you leave a baby behind.
When we started, I thought I understood this. Now that you've read it again, I think I'm more confused than I was.
So it's moved there, and I didn't capture, so it leaves a baby behind. And now you do the same thing.
But on your next move, you could move a baby, is what you're saying?
Yes. And it has to move towards your monkey queen. It has to shorten the distance between it. But I wouldn't really want to do that. I mean, that might come in handy at the end. But I wouldn't want to do that unless it, like, yeah, severely limited your queen, I guess. Because then you could just capture it. I mean, Watson.
Watson.
You just builds up tension, and then you go, I can't move now. That's my experience of playing the game.
Can our monkey queens jump each other?
I do not believe so, but they couldn't do that because if they're lined up, then you just capture it. Oh, okay, yeah. So, monkey... Yeah, we'll do another one. You can't go, like, next to the...
My baby. I got you. Dang, boy, I'm dumb as hell.
Nah. So yeah, there are other rules you can do on this website. Change the clock, change the board size, and change the amount of babies. Nice.
there's got to be some kind of strategy that doesn't involve you just moving one to the left the entire time.
Nah, I won't do that. Oh.
Oh, what?
The baby queens can move like queens.
What? I'm about to lose my mind, folks.
Yeah, baby queens can move like queens. The only restriction they have is they have to move closer to the...
Okay. Gotcha. Oh. Gotcha, boy. Yeah, for people watching this laughing at how stupid we seem, it gets really hard to kind of keep track of all of the possible moves because the board is so open, and also keep track of, like, no, I gotta not, just trying to figure out how to sabotage him. Oh. All right, fam, let's do it.
Oh my god. Ugh.
Do I have to though? Do I have to take it?
Nah. I mean, we can keep going if you want.
Then I'm gonna do you a solid, brother. And we're gonna keep this party on a roll. Good thing they don't move like knights. Let's see if we can get all the way down. No more monkeys.
That seems like, yeah, I said, I think I said that at the beginning. I don't think I've ever got that. And said if you get down to two, you can't make a capture move. I think we were.
Tricky, tricky, tricky. Tricker, tricker, tricker.
I'm in a prison of my own sins. Oh, I did not see that one. What a great way to end.
I thought you weren't allowed to do that, though. Didn't we talk about this in the very first game?
If you have less than two in your Monkey Queen, you're not allowed to capture.
If I have less than two in my Monkey
Queen? Or if you have two or less. So it says, when the Monkey Queen makes it...
I had eight monkeys!
Yeah, so you have more than two. So if you have two or less...
Oh, you said more than two.
Yeah.
If two or less.
You cannot capture.
Okay, when you said two or less, I understood that as two, one, or zero Monkey Queens.
Yeah, if you have two, one, or zero Monkey Queens, then you cannot capture.
Oh, okay, I thought it was that you could not be captured if you had that view.
Whatever, play this game in the future. Thanks for watching.
Yeah, it was a good one.
Post the rules and links below. Goodbye.